friend should be supportive.
Hello, I am here with my friend Khoaula, who is a process engineer. And today we are chatting about process engineering.
Yay!
Whilst we're playing Pictionary. So if you are thinking about doing engineering for your career, or maybe you're just interested in process engineering in general, then this is a chat for you. Mm-hmm. Yes. Our wonderful friend Sarah, she wrote down on a piece of paper what we have to draw.
Oh yeah, there we go.
We've both got one, so we both got different things. So whilst we're having this chat about process engineering, we're going to be playing Pictionary, and at the end we have to guess mm-hmm. what each other's drawing is. Mm-hmm. So tune in for that. Let's go. Are you ready? One,
ready.
Two, three.
Three,
go. What?
Oh my gosh. Okay, I've got this. I've got this.
How can you have that? I think Sarah gave Khoaula an easier one. Okay, fine. What is process engineering?
So it's a very exciting discipline because basically it's one of those that combines a lot of things, among them maths and physics, but also chemistry. So it does offer you a good chance of ending up doing a lot of things, and you can change industries throughout your career. So it's exciting, gives you quite a lot of flexibility, which was what personally one of the things that made me choose it.
So it's basically process engineering is you can take a material like or a resource or something like oil or gas or chemicals or something, and then you turn it into something that's useful for people.
Right. So I personally, I'm in the oil and gas industry, so we work in really large projects or small ones with other disciplines, which is another thing. One of the reasons I chose engineering is that you get to communicate with a lot of different engineering disciplines, and we try to get the oil off the ground or from the sea or whatever, and we try to make it basically fit a certain specification that is normally either set by the client or, for example, a government. So it's basically doing magic.
Doing magic. You've heard
exactly
it here.
So
process engineering is magic.
It sounds so easy in theory, but involves a lot of activities, a lot of different things. It's quite dynamic, so you end up doing things like being on site, doing calculations, attending meetings, talking to the client. It's a lot about problem solving as well, because usually things, most of the time, do not work out. They're not supposed to. But yeah, that's one of the aspects of it. It's all about making it work.
So it could be like chocolate, right? But
correct.
Doing chocolate bars, making chocolate bars, or Cadbury's, that's the whole process.
One of my friends hey, Rachel, if you're watching, she works for Cadbury, and that's what she does.
Does she?
Yeah, she does, in Sheffield. She works at keeping everything under control, so she does something that is called process control, which is an aspect of process or chemical engineering, where basically those machines that you can find on plant, they just don't, you don't just click on a button and it works. You have to monitor them so that you have the right temperature, the right pressure, the right ingredients at the right time, the right duration of the process, which is why it's called a process, because it's different processes that get you to the final product.
Okay, so it's important with chocolate because different chocolate bars need different
parameters
and or characteristics, can we call it?
Correct. Properties. Exactly.
So like the snap
spec,
of
the spec that we talked about earlier. Exactly.
So like the snap of a chocolate bar, that's actually designed, isn't it?
Exactly.
And thought about quite a lot.
Correct. Or not even chocolate, for example, sweets, so you know, gummy bears and things like that. Do you guys ever think about why they're viscous, why they're not, why they're sour, why they're not? That obviously depends on the ingredients, how much you put in.
What about other industries? So there's food industry, there's oil, so energy, like renewable energy, I guess, so biofuels and stuff like that. And pharmaceuticals.
There is quite massive differences between those industries. For example, if you decide to work in the pharmaceutical industry, you work in a completely different environment to the oil and gas. You have to think a lot more about everything being sanitized.
So in a really controlled environment.
Exactly. So all the work and all the measures that you take in your design have to fit with the regulations. Don't show mine. Actually, do you know what?
I'm doing all the talking.
Guys, I know she's asking me the questions for you to know about chemical engineering, but I'm pretty sure she's just trying to keep me occupied.
This is why.
Can you keep in mind this?
I've got a tactic going
on
here.
I see her coming.
Well, Surely as an engineer, you have to be good at multitasking. So really, yeah. We should both be able to stand here and draw and actually talk at the same time.
Okay.
A skill.
It's not good.
One of the things I know people think about is, what do you need to study in order to actually go and do engineering, process engineering?
You can do chemical engineering, but then when you, after you start work, you can go more towards safety, so a process safety. Or you can, if you want, go more towards being on site, or construction, or management, or anything. Chemical engineering is quite a good broad degree that equips you with a lot of skills that are highly, is it called sought after?
Yeah, sought after.
By a lot of employees, so it's a massive plus.
I feel like we should do the reveal. We can do the reveal.
Oh, they're going to see the drawing.
They're going to see the, of course they're going to see the drawing.
You should have said this earlier. This is so embarrassing. It's going to be out there. So this is just a highlight. You can be an engineer, but not good at drawing stuff, which is my case. So
yeah,
I apologise.
I'm going to turn mine over. You're going to turn yours over as well. So we're going to show
We're going to show this to Sarah. She's not biased at all, so.
Okay, I'll look at yours first. So I have to guess what yours is. Okay. I just know it.
A friend should be supportive, and my friend Hayley right here laughing at my, this is not what I expected. All that matters is that she guesses the drawing.
Okay, we're gonna guess this together. It's Tinky Winky, because she wrote Tinky Winky. Tinky Winky is doing a P&ID.
Does it have
drawing,
to be
drawing?
Yeah! Ding, 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 ding.
I don't know who won. We both won. High five. Right, mine.
Wow.
I feel like yours is better.
Mine is better.
Okay.
Is it Minnie? Minnie,
yes.
Minnie Mouse?
Yeah.
There's a pipe. There's a paper. She's doing a pipe. She's a what's the word in English? Not expecting. She's, what is it when you check? What is the word in English?
I can't tell you!
Sorry guys, I'm not English. Oh no!
Near? Yeah. Yes.
Not expecting. No, what's the word in English? Not expecting. Expecting. Inspecting! Oh no!
So what is
She's
it?
Inspector. Minnie Mouse is inspecting a pipe.
Yay!
Do you know what? I'm gonna give her my point because, sorry guys, due to my. This is so good.
I'm really impressed that we managed to get that today.
I'm sorry. Look at the details in the face.
If you have any questions for Khoaula, she will be in my comments at any time answering questions. She didn't know that.
I did not. I actually just learned this now. I know.
Basically, if you have a question, then I will just message Khoaula and I will send her your answer. Your answer.
Yeah,
so thank you very much. See you next time.
Bye bye.